continuing through grid 086 toward the Intercontinental Cargo Launcher. As promised, Carla has agreed to serve as our guide. I'm not sure how safe it is to trust a dozer. But if we turn her down, we turn her knowledge down as well. One more thing, Raven. Cinder, Carla's nickname. That's what the Rubiconians call survivors of the fires of Ibis. But if the fires happened half a century ago... well, it could just be some dozer inside joke. This will be our third sortie together, Raven. I'm quite enjoying the routine.
Main system, activating combat mode.
Here we go, tourist. I'll lead the way, just as promised. But after this, you owe me one. This elevator goes straight to the top of the grid, the outer shell. Sadly, that's beyond my territory. Once you're out there, the PCA satellites see everything. A few of the stupider dozers took it as a challenge, went out to prove themselves. You can guess what happened.
We've arrived at the top, sending you new marker data. It's as Carla said. At this altitude, we're within firing range of the PCA satellites.
Remaining.
Well, nowhere to hide now. Don't get fried.
That's an extremely powerful laser. Be careful, Raven.
Container.
step inside.
Wait. Enemy detected. That machine.
Great. Found a sea weapon. That tourist is a sea spider. One of the Institute's relics left to haunt Lincoln. Now what's it doing here? Tourist. You're Walter's hound, right? Well, I guess a dog can't choose its master. But still, tough luck. I feel sorry for you. I really do. Oh, and one more thing. You know the cargo launcher's strictly for cargo, right? No one's ever used it to launch themselves before. At least not in one piece.
Voices of the coral. currents coursing across Rubicon. Walter was correct in his judgment. The coral. It's here, in this desolate place.